Good morning, students. How are you? Fine. Okay, students. We have already started our grammar topic. So, what are those? Nouns and its kinds. Then abstract noun. Then you did some of the exercises of the abstract noun. Now it comes to countable and uncountable nouns. So, let us see two examples. Riya eats a banana every day. Next. Riya likes bananas. So, what difference did you see? Here it was a banana. It means banana was one, singular. Next, bananas. It means bananas are many, plural form. So, what do we conclude from this example? We use a, an or any number before countable nouns. Next, we can also use singular verb or plural verb before countable nouns. So it is very much clear. If our subject is one, we will use singular verb. If subject is more than one, we will use plural verb. See the example. This apple is delicious. These apples are delicious. So it is very much clear. Here apple was one, so I have used is. Here apples were many, so I have used are. So what do we conclude from all these examples? Let us see the definition of countable noun. Definition of countable noun. The nouns which are countable, that is, we can put a number before them. And they also have their singular or plural forms. You can see from the example. A chair, two chairs. When the chair was one, I haven't put any plural form. It is chair. When I have added number two, it has become chairs. Same way, a pen, three pens. So, countable nouns are those nouns which can be counted easily and which takes the number or a or n before them. Fine. Now comes to uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns. Some nouns are uncountable. They cannot be counted. They never have their plural forms. And we never use plural verb before them. It will be clear by the examples. See, luggage. We never say luggages. Paper, furniture, stationery. These are all example of uncountable noun. We never use their plural forms. Example, she drinks milk every day. Here, I haven't used milks. It is still milk, singular form. It is not clear whether she drinks one glass, two glass. It will be milk. It cannot be milks. She likes milk. Again, uncountable noun, milk. So, we conclude that we cannot use an, n or any number before countable nouns. They only have their singular forms and they never have plural verbs. For example, milk is white. See, milk, it is, since it is uncountable noun, we have used is. The verb is singular. That is what I mean, that we always use singular verb after plural noun. However, there are ways, but now question arises, then how do we count them? We do not count them, we do not put any number before, directly before them. We use count words or measure words to count them. For example, I drank two glasses of juice. Here we are using two glasses. I am counting the glasses. I am not counting the juice. Juice is still singular and it is uncountable noun. So here I drank two glasses of milk. Next is, he has purchased two pieces of furniture. Again, my furniture, this is uncountable. It remains singular. I have counted it as two. Two pieces of furniture. One more example you can say. For example, I purchased three packets of rice. So, rice is uncountable and you are counting the packets. So, it is the container that is counted in uncountable noun and not the uncountable noun. So, students, I have already told you that uncountable nouns do not have plural forms. They do not have a and n or any number before them. And they always take singular verb after them. So here I have already told you in some examples that we never count uncountable noun. We are counting the containers in which they are in. For example, I just told you my father purchased 3 packets of rice. I am counting packets and not the rice. So in the same way, liquids and gases can also be made countable by counting the containers they are in or by the unit of measures. Right? For example, I drink a glass of milk every day. Here you are writing a glass. Milk is uncountable noun. It is singular. Milk is singular. I have used only the quantity, a glass of milk. Next example, I drink 2 liters of milk every day. Here I have changed the measuring unit. I have written 2 liters, but milk again remains the same because it is uncountable. Next, I drink a glass of water. Again, I have used a glass. Water is singular because it is uncountable noun. See some more examples of uncountable nouns. Listen carefully. Rice, salt, flour, cake, cheese, soup, tea, coffee, water, milk, wood, steel, gold, paper, wool, cotton, love, luck, education, advice, evidence, information, fruit, money, news, luggage, subjects like maths, science, economics, English, heat, cold, light, sunshine. Now students, after knowing about countable nouns and uncountable nouns, let us see some words which are used for them. For example, see this diagram. Countable noun, uncountable noun. Few, a few. These words, these you only use for countable noun. For example, I have a few pencils. You cannot say, I have a few juice. It will be wrong. In the same way, we use little, a little for uncountable noun. We will say, I have a little juice, I have a little water in my bottle. In the same way, when you are talking about countable noun, you say how many. For example, how many teachers were there in the staff room. But when it comes to uncountable noun, you ask how much. How much water was there in the pond? How much juice was there in the bottle? Etc. So, what did we conclude? We concluded that uncountable nouns are the substances. They are the concepts that cannot be separated. We cannot count the milk. For example, I drink milk every day. Or I drink 2 bottles of milk or 2 liters of milk. Here I am not counting the milk. I am counting the container or the measuring quantity. Now, let me help solving this exercise. Are these countable or uncountable? Tell me. Chocolate. Chocolate is countable or uncountable? Countable. So you can write CN for countable and UN for uncountable. Apple is again countable. Cheese, it is uncountable. Sugar, uncountable. Car, 1 car, 2 car, so it is countable. Book. I have 2 books, I have 3 books, so it is countable. Television, we have 2 televisions at home, so it is countable. Oil, I cannot say I want 2 oil. I should say I want a bottle of oil, so it should be uncountable. Butter is again a quantity, a substance, a thing which cannot be separated, so it is uncountable. Umbrella is countable, right? Money is again uncountable. Water, many examples we have done. Yes, what is it? Uncountable. Friend, I have two friends, I have three friends. So it is countable. Shoe, countable. Chicken, uncountable. Time, countable. Cup, I purchased two cups from the market, so it is countable. Jam is again a quantity that cannot be separated, so it is uncountable. So students, I hope you must have understood the concepts of countable and uncountable nouns. Thank you. Have a nice day.